try not to paint over the floral accents. Because we're going to do those in that forest green, which is a different color. We don't want to get any of this emerald green on if we can, because it's going to change the color some. I'll get as close as I can to it, then we'll switch to a smaller brush to detail it. And these little symbols here, I believe, are gold. Or at least we're going to do them in gold. I don't know, like I said, looking at it, it's actually, I guess it's a trick of the lights or something. It's really hard to tell the color of it. It looks like it could be gold, but it looks like it could also be that light green. Maybe they put some shimmer, gold shimmer over the light green, which is giving it that illusion. I don't know. What was that thing a couple years ago about the dress? Was it blue or was it gold? And under certain lightings, it was both. I don't know. Just thinking out loud now, guys. Alright, well, if we're gonna do that gold, we can paint over it for now. I will say these are some of the more elaborate carvings I've done. The spring trap last one and this one just has a lot of intricate details. Unfortunately, her costume seems to be the most extravagant, so if we do the other Sanderson sisters next year, they should be a heck of a lot more simple. But as you're all watching this, if y'all are any ideas for a November themed carving, let me know. So I'll be trying to think of something in the meantime. My sister suggested Pugsley from the Addams Family when they're doing the Thanksgiving play where he's dressed up like a turkey, which I was like, okay, that seems kind of cool, but the more I got to think of him, I was like, well, that's still kind of in the vein of Halloween, because it's the Addams Family, even though he's dressed up like a turkey, I don't know. At least it's an option for now. let's darken it up. I have a light purple here, but I didn't realize how old my paint was. It's almost like glue right now, so I don't know how well I'll be able to use it. But we'll see. We'll use that light purple for the sleeves. And then we'll take a little darker, kind of a violet purple, to accentuate those little, like lace style lines. I don't know if that's what they're intended to be, but kind of what they look like. Zealous. Slow it down. Alright, taking shape, guys, taking shape. Let's see, we got this arm to do. Thank you. think once we get this green down, we're gonna move on to the, well, we'll do the purple on the dress. Then we'll move to the face. Sound good with you guys? And these areas, try and cover all our bases, these areas with the floral patterns that we're going to do in a lighter green. To cover our bases, after we do the lighter green, we're going to put a lot of pearlescent powders. Gives it kind of that shimmery, almost glitter type look. We'll go over the lighter green in these floral patterns with a gold pearlescent powder and see if we can't replicate that effect. Alright, well, let's do this collar. Might as well, while I'm over here, right? Yeah, the hand didn't turn out terrible, guys, but it's definitely not a dainty, feminine hand, that's for sure. It's a big, beefy claw of a hand. Part of it was just a design flaw in the template I used, so gotta think things through a little bit better next time.